Welcome to my channel. I have a very important message for all of you. I know in most of the developing countries now, non-invasive ventilation is used very significantly and hopefully in an appropriate manner. And it does save a number of babies because the pathophysiology of RD is when you don't give adequate pressure to start with, the lung starts closing down, the surfactant inactivation happens, exudate comes into the alveoli and denatures existing surfactant as well, and it's a vicious cycle. So the hypoxia, hypercapnia, hypotension, everything sets in, and acidosis as well. So if you don't manage these babies with appropriate pressure support from the beginning, they go into a cycle. So it's very welcome that we use non-invasive ventilation, which can be CPAP, high flow, indigenous CPAP or NAPPV if you have the facility, in a timely fashion appropriately. But I have a very important message and a request. Before you start setting up non-invasive ventilation in your unit, please get blenders or a compressed air source which you can use indigenously to get air oxygen mixture to the baby. So giving 100% oxygen through pressure devices like CPAP is going to deliver a high FaO2 into the lungs, and obviously a PaO2 goes up, and hyperoxia related lung injury as well as high risk of ROP happens. So please don't take hyperoxia lightly. You may be helping the baby in the short run. There are some babies who definitely need NAV, but there are many babies who may improve even without NAV. And if you're using 100% oxygen, you may actually be harming these babies rather than helping them. So if your hospital is hesitant to get these devices, ensure that you request them in a way that they understand the importance. Parents are becoming more aware, and it is a medico-legal issue if ROP is prominent. The guidelines for ROP, for example, the national guidelines in India recommend ROP screening from babies below 34 at or below 34 weeks, or even weight of 2 kilo, compared to gestation of 31 and below, and weight below 1.5 in the developed world. So this is a huge number of babies that need additional ROP screening, and most likely reason that we get aggressive ROP in these babies is because we are using oxygen without using blenders. So please do share this message and take the leadership, take the initiative to discuss with your management. Short-term gains should not lead to serious visual vision loss or major issues. So the near-term babies who may improve without your non-invasive ventilation may actually develop blindness because you're giving 100% oxygen to these babies. So think carefully before you do any treatment. Try your best. There are indigenous options if you can't afford a blender. You need compressed air source, which again, your hospital has to support you, or you need to buy get cylinders for compressed air and connect it as well. So it's not easy, but you need to first focus on it as an important point and then get going with that. I hope you'll take this message seriously, and thank you so much. Do share with all your colleagues. Thank you.